Well, he is Charlotte's first murder victim of the year, but he was also an accomplished photographer missed by friends at a local publication. And his accused killer is charged with first-degree murder. News Channel 36 reporter Glenn Counts is live from the Mecklenburg County Courthouse, where the suspect appeared this afternoon. Glenn?
Sonia, because of the charges, there wasn't a chance that Antoine Young was going anywhere other than back to jail. Now, none of his family or friends showed up in court to speak for him, but the friends of the victim say that he will be truly missed. Police say that Monday, Chris Raddick got off work, went to his East Charlotte home, and walked in on a burglary. He was stabbed multiple times during a violent struggle and became Charlotte's first murder victim of the year.
The night before, I'd actually seen the little blurb about Charlotte's first murder, and, you know, I didn't click on it. I was thinking, you know, it's never anybody you know.
Matt Brunson is the movie critic for Creative Loafing. He worked with Raddick for many years. The 55-year-old man was a photographer. This is one of the covers he shot. Brunson was stunned to learn that his friend was dead.
Why do something this senseless to a fellow human being? Why take their life away from them? Especially if it's just for material gains.
A Facebook memorial page has been set up for Raddick. Brunson still thinks about the good times and his friend's unique sense of humor.
You look on the Facebook tribute page and people are like, you know, when I first met him, he was kind of like, it made me like get scared. But if you know him personally, he was such a nice, genuine guy.
29-year-old Antoine Dion Young was arrested and charged with murder, robbery with a dangerous weapon, and larceny.
Well, I may be a liberal writing for a liberal newspaper, but I'm not a bleeding heart liberal, so I'm all for the severest punishment possible.
Well, the SUV that Young allegedly stole on Monday was found yesterday. He could potentially get the death penalty in this case, but prosecutors have not yet decided whether or not they will seek it. His next court appearance is scheduled for the 24th of this month, and that will be a bond hearing. Reporting live from our mobile newsroom here at the Mecklenburg County Courthouse, Glenn Counts, News Channel 36.